it's not such a foreign thing. Like, I know it gets convoluted because it's business involved and it plays out in front of the public. I get all of that. But everybody here has friends, and everybody here goes through things with their friends. And that's where we are in real time.
Yo, and I hear it like if you don't want.
I'm not doing an interview neither, Sam. I just came because this is a private matter, as it should be amongst friends. But I just came in here to say what's going on and to say who cares about any of that, as long as you check on your friends. That's it.
Joe, I just have one question for you, Joe.
I have one question for you. My question
was
just...
Hey, one mic, man.
What the fuck?
Yeah, one mic.
Hey, start moving, niggas, man.
Nah, don't move nobody to the... Don't move nobody to the audience. I just want to say this real quick. So, like, it's cool you're here. It's not an interview. That's not my purpose. But you can just chill out here, but we're just going to continue the conversation. So I want to let the people in the audience know we can just keep the conversation going the way that we were having it and just, you know, just keep talking. You know what I mean? Don't hold nothing back. Let's just keep it going.
Yeah, Joe, I can say I was here for a little bit earlier too, listening in. It was healthy, you know, conversation, varying points of views and things like that. I did clear up some misconceptions about some things real quick, and then I scaled off. But it was healthy. It wasn't anything super polarizing, and I can't say.
Listen, I don't never mind if it's unhealthy.
I was just asking him if he felt a certain pressure, like as a black entrepreneur, you know, because we were talking about before how, like, it's always about people are bringing up Joe's, like, you know, business failures in the past and stuff like that. And it's like, we don't give, you know, our black brothers the same benefit of the doubt, or sisters, black sisters as well. You know, like, I just wanted to ask Joe personally about that. Like, that trauma that he may go through behind the scenes, like, as he's trying to build up his base and his, you know what I'm saying, like, his media business.
Not no interview.
Oh, let
him say no interview.
I know, nigga, just keep talking.
So let him ask.
No, don't even
y'all
have
y'all got scared.
Y'all responded.
Yo, whoa, like, hold on. Chris, relax.
Y'all don't want to speculate right now.
Y'all move me to the audience just because I was asking a question?
Wait. Let me say this real quick. Chris, I don't want niggas to start using words like that. Like, don't say niggas got scared. Niggas not scared. He said, yo, like, I don't want this to be an interview. And I said, we've been talking before he was here, so let's keep the conversation going how it's been going. If the nigga don't want to really talk, that's cool. If he wants to speak, he can just unmute his mic and say some shit, answer the question, whatever. But, yo, don't do, like, niggas are scared or whatever. That's not the case.
Yeah, so that's what I was saying. I was saying this half the conversation is normal. I ain't saying niggas are scared.
Somebody was like, yo, now that Joe is in here, y'all scared. Don't do that. All right, so keep going, whoever was speaking.
That was Clue. But, I mean, I got to move to the audience just you know.
Yo,
I was
don't
just
move,
saying,
don't
like,
move niggas to the audience, man.
I was just saying that if people are going to speak in respect to Joe, for example, like, we cannot be putting down our brothers and sisters as we're trying to raise up through, like trying to build our own media empires. We give everyone else the benefit of the doubt, but when it comes to us building our own bases, we seem to, like, you know, minimize the time and the effort that went into building that base. So I'm saying don't bring up, like, people's past failures in business. Everybody has failures. The Chase CEO, Jamie Dimon, it took him until he was 40 or 50 to even really get on. Robert Smith, who Kanye just passed. Kanye is now the you know, richest black man in America. But 2 weeks ago, it was Robert Smith. He didn't start his first $1 billion company until he was 40 something.
Hey, yo, wait a second.
Let me ask you a question, because I brought this up before. I'm gonna bring it up again, right? Remember, there was Rockefeller, and then it turned into Rock Nation, right?
Mm-hmm.
And some people had to be left behind, right? At that point in time, niggas was like, yo, what the fuck is going on? How is Jay gonna survive this shit? So, you know what I mean?
I was the one who was saying before that Joe can do it himself.
And Kanye is not the richest white man in America.
Let me ask you this question. Is it a situation where Joe is transitioning to his network and some people just got to be left behind?
I'm saying that's up to him because he's the central focus of the show. It's called the Joe Budden Podcast. That we appreciate Rory and Maul. We appreciate them because just like how we watch television shows and there are certain characters that we're drawn to, like Game of Thrones, we love certain characters, but certain characters are left out. It doesn't minimize the addition that they add, like whatever they added to the show. But at some point, like Joe as the central focus is going to have to see, like, if shit meshes with what he's doing as he's rising up the scale.
But Clue, why would we even have
Clue, why would we even have that discussion when I just witnessed Joe and Joe is in the room to be able to confirm this? He said very clearly, this is Rory's seat. This is Ma's seat.
Yes, because
it's not going anywhere. So I don't understand why we're speculating to that extent.
I'm not speculating.
But he's here.
Hold on, y'all. He's here, but if Joe is not talking, then we are.
Yeah, he doesn't have to answer.
And that's okay.
So then, in that vein, since if he's not going to speak to address that, I'm going to go off of what I physically saw him say.
Go ahead.
I don't feel the necessity to expand my horizons in speculation when he made it very clear that these two seats belong to his co-hosts, no matter who he brings up, Imani or anybody else for that matter, to take those spots while they're getting air.
Hold on. I hope I'm saying your name right. But if Joe is the reason why those seats are empty and those niggas don't come back, isn't that a decision that Joe made?
What my context is that the whole reason why this show existed or why the complex show existed is because Joe is the main product. He is the one that executed the contract with Revolt. He is the one Diddy sought out to begin to create State of the Union and this particular podcast and getting the funding to do this. So if Joe sees two of his principal characters actually getting into something that could be disruptive for the show as a lead principal product, he has the ability to come in and say, guys, I see what's going on. We're all friends. These are your seats. They're not going anywhere. Get some air. That to me is a logical business decision for the lifetime of the show.
That's brilliant.
That's a fact.
But that's like somebody.
But if they don't want to, if they don't want to do that, take that step back. Or if it feels like an order.
No problem. Hey, but hold on, right. He said they are friends. Though at the end of the day, these people are friends. So no matter what these guys go through, at the end of the day, they're gonna be friends, and that's what everybody needs to know. Friends have discords. No matter what the situation, he said, if they, no matter what, these seats are for them. He don't give a damn if he bring the Pope. Guess what? Them his friends, and he fuck with them. What part of that we don't get
on that show? That's what I was saying earlier.
Yeah. Hey, I'm not reading the names. But fuck yeah.
Hey, I'm fucking with
you.
Hey,
everybody earlier, y'all letting all of this.
No, Kimberly, you gotta hit him with the hard questions.
Let Joe
talk for a minute, man. Try to talk for 5 minutes.
Listen, one mic. Let Joe, he's here. Listen, one mic. Let him talk. Y'all wanna hear you?
Kimberly. Joe's actually the one trying to speak. It's just speaking over him.
I'm just saying there are no hard questions when you're talking about friendship. Like, business, cool. There's a million businesses. There'll always be that. But when you spot some shit that from your eye just ain't really right as a friend, and this is only from my brain, of course. I'm not speaking for anybody else. Then you do whatever's best to improve the situation. And I'll be honest, speaking as a network head and podcast host, there are some signs, some tall tale signs that I just missed. I missed them. I didn't see it. I'm sorry, I was busy. Network, pod over here. You're not going to see it all. And as you're attempting to build something, you kind of need friends.
Facts.
You kind of need people that you trust. People that you can have intense conversations with, people that have a run with you, kind of know where your heart lie. And if those things aren't right in podcast world for me, then fuck this podcast.
Hey, Joe, I got a question.
For real though.
Friends over everything. Hey, that's what I'm here.
Man, you need a link over. I can get some money for real.
Yo.
No. Yo. Beta over everything.
Yo, he out of pocket.
Yo. Do y'all contract with that shit? Like, in the new contract, do y'all have to run the show? Like, did you have to run it?
I'm not here to talk about nobody's contract. What I will say is that we are blessed.